Hello folks, in this video I'm going to show you what happens when with the tuning when temperature changes. To do that, I of course I have to change the temperature of the string, and for that I use this power supply over here. I have two connectors, and what I do is I put the voltage over the string, I put the power supply on, and then the current gives the heat in the string and the temperature goes up. The other thing I have is this tuner. It's a vintage tuner, and what I've done is I have tuned the pitch of what is usually the high E string. I've raised it to a G, so I've stretched it almost to the breaking point. So now I will show what happens. First, what you see is it's a G, and now I will put on the power supply. If you look and you listen carefully, you can see that it will drops, and it will drop about 10 cents. If you have a drop of 50 cents, five times more, then you are a complete note out of tune. So, now I've changed the setup a bit. What I've done is tuned the high E string to a low G string. The same as you have the G string on a solid body guitar, the unwound G string. So it's an one octave lower than in the previous example. What I've also done is I made the scale shorter. I've put a clamp over here, and the scale instead of this is now this. So a shorter scale and a much lower tension in the string. So we will have a look. It's a G, and now I put on the power supply, and it's the same string, the same power supply. Don't have changed any settings, so the heat is exactly the same. So the power supply, and of course it heats a few seconds. And when we have a look, we see that the change in pitch, it's in the range, is almost 50 cents. So slowly it goes up again. So you've seen that in this example, with a shorter scale and the tune it one octave lower, so the tension in the string is much less. You see that it's more than doubled the shift over temperature. In the next part of this video, I will show you in a more theoretical way what causes the effect of temperature, and also how serious the problem is, because what I've done over here is just put some current through the string and the temperature goes up, but it's more as an indication what can happen. And with the theory, we have more absolute idea what we can expect in practical situations. So when we have to figure out what happens when the temperature rises, and how that affects the tuning of the guitar, we'll have a look at the temperature coefficient of materials. Temperature coefficient is often given by the letter alpha, and we have two materials which are important in the guitar. Draw the guitar over here. So like this, it's an arch guitar, of course. Then we have the string here, and that has a temperature coefficient we call alpha S.
from steel, because the string is made of steel. And usually we have the material from the guitars made of wood. And steel and wood have different temperature coefficients. For steel, we have a value of 12 parts per million for each temperature. And the temperature coefficient is given by the relative change in length divided by the total length. So if we have a string here at this length, and we heat it up in temperature, it will expand. There will be extra material in this number, and this is the value for each degree in temperature. This is the change. What happens when there is extra material in the string, when it's fixed between this point and this point, and you've got extra material? Well, it will drop, it will hang out, and if you heat it very much, it loses all its tension. So what happens with the frequency? The frequency will go down. On the other hand, we have the wood, and we will write the temperature coefficient of the wood with the W. And for wood, we have a different temperature coefficient, and that is about 6 parts per million for each degree. And if the whole structure of the guitar will expand, it will stretch the string tighter and tighter, and the frequency will go up. So these two effects go in the opposite direction. In case that we have made the frame here, for instance, from steel, which is for a piano and a grand piano, then both effects compensate. The difference between the less stress in the string and the stress by the frame or the structure will exactly compensate. And there's almost no effect for temperature. But because these two are different, we have an effect. If we look at the total length and we take both temperature coefficients in consideration, we can write the total difference in length by temperature is the total length, let's say the scale of the guitar, and then the difference between the steel and the wood, and of course multiplied by the temperature. So this is an important thing. This is the total stretch of the whole guitar when it's in balance with temperature. With normally the heat up of the string goes much faster than of the whole guitar. So, but when you wait, let's say for a half an hour, then the whole thing is in complete thermal balance. Okay, step. So now we've seen how much the guitar string stretches over temperature, and now we want to know how that affects the frequency of the string. For that we have a look at the equation for the frequency of the string, and that is given by frequency is 1 divided by 2 times the scale of the string and the square of tensile strength divided by the specific mass. The specific mass is, for instance, for steel, is about 8,000 kilograms per cubic meters. The tensile strength is the force divided by the surface of the string. So if we have a string over here and we pull stretches with the force F. We divide it by this area of the string, it's called A, and then we have the tensile strength. We see when we have a change in length, we see only a length over here. But there is another length, and that is the effect of stretching on the tensile strength. And for that we have to look at an equation which is given by the modulus of elasticity is the tensile strength divided by the strain. Now we have to look closer to the string. This is this, and that is given by the relative stretching of the string. That is this value. This is important. Now we have a closer look at modulus of elasticity, the tensile strength and the strain. If we make a graph and we in this direction we put the strain, which is the relative stretching of a string, and in this direction we put the tensile strength, the force divided by the surface of the string, then we see this effect. And the modulus of elasticity is the tangent over here. Because here we have E. And when we stretch the string further and further, the modulus of elasticity will drop. You see, over here we have this value, and over here we have this value, and when we stretch further and further the modulus of elasticity drops, but so there is a point that the string will break, and the operating point is where is the string tuned to the right pitch, and what region are we using the string. For instance, a grand piano, all the strings have the operating points almost to the breaking point. Let's say over here. And for a guitar, it depends a bit on which string we have. If we have the high E string, this is almost to the edge of breaking, it's over here. But when we have, for instance, an unwound G string, then we have the operating point over here. So this is the high E, and this is here an unwound G string. So important to see is that we have now, you see, we have tensile strength, we have modulus of elasticity and the strain, and we can write now the stretching by temperature as follow. We had derived that the stretching was the scale, temperature, and the difference between the temperature coefficients. And we can write that the strain is the total of the stretching by the total length of the guitar, and we can write that as what we initially did with tuning. This is delta L1, that is the stretching by tuning, but there is something extra, and that is by temperature. And we write it LT. Divide it by L. So this is our new strain. Now we can say that the tensile stress is the strain multiplied by the modulus of elasticity. So we can write for the tensile stress so, and we are going to put this value in our frequency equation. So now we find an equation for the tensile strength as function of temperature. We put that in the equation of the frequency of the string, and we find now the frequency of the string as function of temperature is 1 divided by 2 times scale. The initial stretching by the tuning. And we add the effect of the temperature, and we divide it by L and the specific mass. And now we want to know how much changes the frequency for each degree, and then we have to take the derivative of this function, and that is of the temperature. And we can write, it's a bit of a calculation, but I won't do that. I only will write the final results. So this is the effect of temperature on frequency of the string. So we see if we stretch the string almost when to the breaking point, the modulus of elasticity will go down, and it has a very good effect on the temperature effect, because the temperature effect also goes down, so it's much less sensitive for temperature when you stretch a string almost to the breaking point. It's a good thing on grand pianos, they stretch it almost to the breaking point, and at the same time they use the same material for the frame and the string, so it's in almost perfect balance. Very good design of an instrument. We also see that when we have a short scale, the effect on temperature goes up, so it's not very good for temperature effect to have short scale. It's not good at all, because it gives a lot of problems on other subjects as well. And here we see that the tensile strength, the more you stretch a string, the lower the effect on temperature. When we calculate this equation, and we let's say for a G string, on a unwound G string, in a regular scale of 64 centimeters, we have 2 cents for each degree. So if your guitar changes about let's say 10 degrees, you shift 20 cents, and that is almost half a note. This is very clearly to hear. This. And when we have the high E string, with much more tension, and the modulus of elasticity is lower, because it's almost stretched to the breaking point, then we have a value, we can calculate 1.3 cents. So that's considerably lower. Okay, so this is what we see. The effect on temperature on a more mathematical way.
What we have seen from the equations is that different strings have different tension, and the tension determines how much the drift is over temperature, and that means that not all strings change the same with temperature. So even when you play your guitar alone and you are coming from a cold space to a warm stage, the whole guitar will detune, but not all the strings detune the same. So over temperature, the you can't play a guitar when it changes too much in temperature. The change in temperature is between 1 and 2 cents for each degree. So if you have a temperature change of, let's say, 5 degrees, it would absolutely very noticeable that your guitar is going out of tune, even when you play it alone and not with other musicians. What also was clear from the equation was that if you have short scale guitars, the tension of all strings is less and you have much more problems with temperature effect. So, well, I hope you learned a bit about temperature and guitars, and I hope you don't find the equation part too boring. So thank you for watching.